So every day, we use modern technology in some shape or form to get answers to our most pressing questions. But what we don't always think about when we're asking these questions is that our most pressing questions are often also our most personal ones. And so really, just by virtue of making a search query on an app, on a website, or to a chatbot, we're often revealing sensitive information about ourselves. Information like our location history, our medical conditions, or maybe our job status. And unfortunately, the instant that we make our search query, we're giving up the control over our data, and this isn't always a good thing. In the real world, our data might be sold to advertising partners, it might be shared with third parties, it might be stored in data centers, and perhaps even stolen in a data breach. Now, in this talk, I'm going to argue that we no longer need to be taking these privacy risks. We're on the brink of being able to use modern cryptography to not only get access to all of the information that we desire, but do so without paying the price of our own privacy. So let me give you a little bit of background on how search, or in technical terms, information retrieval works. The way it works when we make a query is that our query is shipped off to some server that's responsible for handling our request. And while our query is in transit, it's going to be protected so that anyone who might be eavesdropping in on our network traffic can't learn anything about what we're searching for. However, the server is going to read our query, and this is important so that, after all, our server can answer our query and then ship the answer back to us, right? But there's a drawback here, which is exactly what I just mentioned. The server gets to read our query. And because of this, the server can infer information about us, in this case, that we might all today be in Boston, Massachusetts, and over time, really build a pretty detailed and accurate profile of who we are. The good news is that this isn't the only way of doing things. Now, this might sound like science fiction, but we can actually use cryptography to ask a question to a server and have the server answer our question without learning anything about what our question was. So this technique is called private information retrieval, and it works by having the user send up an encryption of its search query to the server. Now, our server is really going to learn nothing about the user's query in a strong cryptographic sense. And this is because all the server sees is this encryption, which looks like just a sequence of completely random bits to anyone who doesn't know the secret key. However, it turns out that using properties of the underlying encryption scheme, our server can actually still compute the answer to our search query under encryption and then ship this back to us. Okay, so you might wonder, this sounds fantastic. Why don't we use this all over the place? And unfortunately, the reason is because private information retrieval is still prohibitively slow. So for our server to be able to compute the answers to our queries under encryption, it needs to perform many very heavy cryptographic operations, and this is going to require either a lot of time or a lot of physical machines. So really, this is sort of an unsatisfying state of affairs. We have the perfect cryptographic tool for the problem, but we just can't use it. In my research, I aim to fix this and to make private information retrieval fast enough for you and me to use in practice. With my collaborators here at MIT and at Google, we have built the fastest known encryption scheme for this task, and I want to just give you a tiny little taste of how this works. The key idea is that we're going to actually be able to let our server perform 99.9% of its cryptographic operations once ahead of time. And so then, whenever a user shows up, the user can just download a short summary of these cryptographic operations from the server, and then use this summary to make its encrypted query. And now, at this point, when the server gets the query, it can perform the remaining only 0.1% of operations and then send the answer back to the client. And really, this 0.1% here is a tiny fraction, so this can actually be quite fast. And the true beauty here is that the server's pre-computation did not depend on the user's query in any way. And so this means that the user can reuse the same summary of the server's pre-computation to make as many queries as she would like, always with just a tiny fraction of the server's operating cost. So with this encryption scheme, we built the fastest known system for private information retrieval. And the system is roughly an order of magnitude faster than the best previous systems, and roughly 5 orders of magnitude faster than the very first systems for private information retrieval that were developed in the 1990s, in part here at MIT. And really, the power that this gives us is that we can now search over hundreds of millions of documents privately with only a cent of compute power. And to give you an idea of what this buys you, for example, all of Wikipedia consists of roughly 60 million articles, and so it could be readily searched over in these costs. So with that, I'd just like to zoom out a little bit and put this research in the bigger picture. The last 50 years of innovation have really been about putting information at our fingertips. And this has been a huge success story, right? Today we can search over and we can synthesize the entire wealth of human knowledge with a click. In the next 50 years of innovation, we're going to have to think really hard about how to protect and secure our information. And this means protecting our data, protecting our users, and protecting our interests. And we can do this with cryptography. Thanks so much.